5 seconds. I am really very happy to inaugurate this very useful seminar. I am sure that your deliberations will serve as a guidance to everyone who is interested in a democratic form of government. At the outset, I should like to tell you what a democratic government expects from the press. I think in the normal circumstances, any government will certainly welcome criticism from the press. It does not matter how severe the criticism is, provided it is free from malice and ill will. As a matter of fact, well-meaning constructive criticism is very necessary for the healthy growth of any democracy. A government would naturally like the newspapers to help them in bringing before the public the various welfare activities of the nation, like the 5-year plans, family welfare schemes, etc. The press should always maintain an atmosphere favorable to the development of the country. It is really a test for a newspaper. We would like the newspapers to give due publicity to the good causes in the country and to discourage evil and wrong tendencies. The average reader of a newspaper does not mind very much about what a newspaper writes on a political, economic, or academic issue. He will consider it as the viewpoint of a particular individual or a group, and he may agree with it or may disagree with it. He may or may not be affected by it, but when a newspaper gives an incorrect item of news through big misleading headlines, which will create ill feelings among certain sections of the people, it will do a lot of harm to the public cause. Therefore, in such matters, the responsibility of the press becomes very great indeed. I should like to take this opportunity to make a special personal appeal to you to keep this aspect of the matter in mind. I do not very much mind if those in charge of running the newspapers do not fall in the line with the thinking of any particular party, including the one to which I belong. I do not expect this from the press. At the same time, I would like you not to write an article or publish a big headline which is likely to have serious repercussions among the various sections of the people. I repeat this aspect again, as I am convinced that it is worthwhile repetition any number of times. I only want to impress upon you that I should be the duty of every responsible newspaper to avoid doing such a thing. I would even go a step further and also suggest to you that every one of you should endeavor to create a proper atmosphere in the newspaper world, so that such a thing cannot happen. I hope you will give serious consideration to this suggestion. Like most things in the world, newspapers are also undergoing changes. Only recently, there was much talk in England of the gradual absorption of newspapers by some enterprising combines, with the result that there are fewer independent newspapers outside these major combines. I still have my old ideas. I do not like large chains of newspapers or combines concentrating on mass circulation. It is obvious that such concentration comes in the way of a free press. This tendency, which is seen in some of the democratic countries, is on the whole unfortunate. We are entering a definite stage in India when the newspaper reading public is growing at a very fast rate. We find that this growth is mainly in the language newspaper readers. After the introduction of compulsory education and the drive to banish illiteracy, the number of persons who can read newspapers has considerably increased, but most of them go in for newspapers in the regional languages. The editors of newspapers and others in charge of running them should take note of this phenomenon. They should try to cater to the needs of those who may not be well read and who may not be in a position to read English newspapers. Newspapers are evolving in such a way that nobody can foresee the future. In the ultimate analytics, their evolution is governed by technological changes. I want changes, but I am afraid that in certain respects, the basic standards are not maintained. If the basic standards go to pieces, any change that you may introduce will have to start on wrong foundations and will lead us in wrong directions. So the responsibility of the newspapers and writers is much greater than that of many other people who try to mold public opinion, I should therefore like you to lay stress on the basic aspects and the constructive side of presentation of news. Let me now conclude by offering my good wishes for the successful conduct of this very useful seminar. Thank you.